Alright guys, so final video for the day. As you can see, I reached the main road. So, that's about it. So I'm going to turn around and head back to the car. Beautiful here. I just wish there was more trails. Virginia is a beautiful state. Everything's restricted here. Unless you know someone with acres of property, you drive 3 or 4 hours. Trails illegally, if I don't realize, I do it seldomly. The chance you're going to take is have some fun. When I head back, I'm going to do the review for California. It's really restricted for dirt bikes. I'm not doing it for ATV-wise or anything. Yeah, there's just a lot of big boulders and deep rocky ruts and everything. So it's kind of disappointing. I had to turn around almost like 10 times on different trails. Just because it's not enjoyable going 1 mile an hour with your feet on the ground, trying to get past big rocks. There were a few nice trails there. It started to rain, so I really didn't get to explore as much as I'd want. There's always next time. Yeah, so I give it a 5 overall. For location, I give it a 7.5. It's pretty much a straight shot. It's easy to get to. In a beautiful area. It's basically 4 miles off of an interstate. So it's not like you have to go on a bunch of windy roads, especially if you're towing a trailer or whatnot. Well, this might be something good here. It's a dirt road. Yeah. But if you have an ATV, side-by-side, something like that, you're going to be in heaven there. Dual sport, especially if you have a heavy one. There's a guy there. Him and his brother are there. They're riding a DRZ 400 and a Honda 650 dual sport, which is crazy because I was talking to him and asked how many miles were on his Honda. He said this guy had 24,000 miles on that thing, still going on strong. He actually said that the guy drove with him. They went all the way up to New Hampshire from Virginia, and he did it on his 650 dual sport Honda. I forget the name of the Honda. That is nuts. 24,000 miles. I think it was an 07 or 05. So he's riding a lot, which is good. I hate to see guys buy these things and sit in the garage. They don't put them to good use. But, yeah, I thought that was a little bit crazy myself. This just leads to someone's yard here. Damn it. But George Washington National Forest and Jefferson Forest, there's more places to go. I was just at the Tasker's Gap area. So, I'm not saying that the whole forest area is bad, just where I was wasn't very great for dual sport. I had my hopes up. Wasn't what I thought it was going to be. wasn't what I anticipated. So yeah. As always, next time. I just started vlogging. I just figured out that I can kind of jerry-rig my phone into my helmet. And if I sound muffled, I'm sorry. It's because my mouth is right on the speaker. As you can see here, or as you can see in the mirror, that's how I have my set up there. But I just need to get a damn GoPro already. I'm putting it off too long. Yeah. But don't get disappointed by what I'm saying to you about the forest and all that. Go see for yourself. I mean, it might be something you can enjoy. I saw family, they had some four-wheelers, and they had some little boys, they had like little Honda 50s and 80s and stuff like that, and they were gone for a while, so I'm pretty sure they were keeping up with the four-wheelers and the trails. I mean, those bikes are small, so yeah. So I mean, don't let me deceive your opinion on that. Go see for yourself if you're around the area. The bike's going for sale, like I said, 1,000 times before. In a few months, I'll keep it posted. Looking for a KLR 650, so if you know anybody that's selling one in the tri-state area, let me know. My price range is $5,000 and under. I'm looking for something with 4,000 miles, 3,000 miles or less on the bike. And they're out there. If you want to settle for a trade or something, if you want to trade for something smaller and get rid of your KLR, I'll be more than happy to trade with you and put some cash down on top of the trade. Don't get me wrong, the KLX is a great bike. Reliable. I drove it all the way from West Virginia, 3 hours, about 140 miles. It was fine, didn't overheat, the light didn't come on. Good. The only thing that I wish it was better on is the highway. I mean, it's fine on the highway for about 10-20 miles, but it really started to get to you after a while. There's a deer there, so slow down. Yeah, it's fine, but I mean, around town, it's great. It gets 65-70 miles a gallon. 2-gallon tank, small, I know. But I fill up about every 120 miles, give or take. So, not a bad bike. I mean, this is the first motorcycle I've owned. I'm 23. I've ridden dirt bikes my whole life. So this is why I kind of jumped to the 250. But now, as they all say, you always want something bigger. And I want to start doing some adventure touring and long distance drives. So, that's why I went to KLR, tried and true bike. So yeah, and if you guys have one, you want to give me your feedback on it, or you know somebody that has one, just comment on my page and let me know what you think about it. I'd love to hear from guys that have had them for a while and put the miles up on it. I was looking at a vlog one time and I saw a guy on KLR 650. He got 100,000 miles on it. So, yeah, let me know. Thank you.